for those who subscribe to the politics of integrity, equity, and conscience. They are the ones that use politics as a platform to aggregate the people's energies and potentialities to create a better society for all. For a respected legislator and leader in the House, he has earned his stripe. In a parliament like the Federal House of Representatives, with members from different political parties representing various interests, he reiterates on the major focus of the House since inauguration.
The focus of the House has been Nigeria and Nigerians. And I put that, you know, on the front burner, and we've allowed that focus to determine and inform most of the decisions we make in the House till date. And that is, to me, if I want to sum it up in a nutshell, that is what I'll say is the focus of the House of Representatives of
Nigeria,
and the best, whatever will be in the best interest of Nigeria and Nigerians. I realize that that's the only way you can actually effect it, that you can participate in other ways.
Cut across to people.
To at least have a direct impact, as it were. That is not to say that you cannot impact on people in your own little sphere, and I encourage people to do that. But in terms of influencing policies, influencing legislation, being involved actively and directly and frontally, I think that occurred to me, quite honestly, like I said, it's always been inherent in me. It's always been there. But I realized early, probably about 20 years ago, just do the right thing. Just do what you perceive to be the right thing. Just follow your heart, follow your conscience, and use your head. That's my philosophy. I've been in the National Assembly upwards of 10 years, about 12 years now. This is my third term. So I, at the risk of sounding vain, I cannot begin to recount the things I may have done in my
constituency. It's a normal process. It has been a normal process.
I've been doing it for upwards of 12 years. So I cannot begin to recount what I've done, But one thing I'm always proud of, and I like to point amongst several things that I've done, will be the first ever of its kind in Lagos and in Nigeria, at least organized by an elected representative, which is the job fair, which I organized for my constituents and the people of Lagos last year. It's called the Surulere Job Fair, because I realized, you know, the problem of unemployment. When I was campaigning in 2011 and seeking for re-election, at every stop that I made to talk to people, to campaign, everybody spoke with one voice. Young, old, women, men, Yoruba, Igbo, Northerners, in my constituency, they all spoke with one uniform request, and that was the problem of unemployment. Now, amazing, we had about over 5,000 applicants who were looking for employment. Cost me a lot of money. I pumped my money into it, spoke to several companies, took a lot of time and a lot of effort. And I wanted to seize this opportunity to thank those companies. It was a two-day job fair. And at the end of the day, it produced, or we were able to employ over 300 people in those 2 days. Now, so to answer your question, I have identified one thing. There's several other things which I think my constituents will be in a better position. They're visible things. They're hospitals, they're clinics, they're classroom blocks, they're buildings, we call poverty elevation. This is generally all sorts. I've done work that the street lights, I've done work that belongs even to the local government, that is in the province of the local government.